that's where it started.
Well, we do, because we're not here all the time. We keep a lot of things in there we don't want to take it, so we have to lock it, unfortunately.
How do you
One of the things out here is you see a lot of people who have some problems in our society, a lot of hungry people, a lot of people with mental illness. We just had, in fact, a soldier go by who injured a crossing in Iraq. He had, like, a brain injury. And he was acting kind of strangely, so we had to work with him to take care of him, make sure he didn't harm anybody. So we do see that kind of thing down here. So we lock our tent in order to... The reason we're out here is we want the public to see us. There's all sorts of signs that people can walk around and show you something. Signs talking about...
Look at that dog!
Work this having rights, yeah? Look at the regular. It's a very smart dog, by the way.
Look!
Look
at that dog!
Yeah, we want people to understand that they have rights, so they can stand up. So they can stand up and they can speak for themselves. We're trying to give a voice to people who've been ignored. And that's the idea. This country right now is controlled by a lot of people with lots of money.
1% against the 99%.
We call ourselves the 99% movement because most people in this country are struggling financially. Only 1% is not. The 1% has the wealth of the 95%. It's kind of a strange thing, but that's how it's developed. So we're trying to change that. We're trying to bring this the people's voice out, make sure they get heard, and that we really have a government by the people that we're supposed to have.
What?
Can we have more people, more food? Yes, we'll get more food in a second.
After, hold on a second.
I'm hungry.
So you have a nice future.
So what, you tell me that they're studying some social justice stuff.
Yes.
What are you guys talking about so far?
I go. So Brother Kevin asked, well, who are some of the leaders that stood up for something right that we have learned about? Somebody raise your hand and tell me about one of the leaders that we've learned about. Anybody? Yes, yeah, Sister Matoli. Mahatma Gandhi, what did he stand
Gandhi
up for?
That's a good one.
He stood up for the rights of, well, him and his fellow people.
His fellow people, who are his people?
Me,
India.
Free India, yeah.
Yes.
And he fasted, and he got arrested by the police multiple times, but he still kept going.
Very All right, good. Thank you. Who are some of the other folk? Yes, thank you, Sister Matoli.
We studied Nelson Mandela.
Oh, that's a good
And
one.
He stood up for what?
South Africa.
Excellent.
South Africa. That's right. He did go to jail.
Exactly.
Very good. Okay. Somebody, who else did we study? Anybody else who stood up for good in the face of not so good?
He's got all the answers.
He's got all the answers, maybe. I don't know. Yes. Eric Weinmeier. Tell us about Eric Weinmeier.
He went back. So, and then he was... It was seven of the tallest mountains.
He climbed seven of the tallest mountains.
And he was back. And so they make him ring. They was, like, the person, they made him, they was ringing the bell when Eric Weinmeier had to follow him while he was climbing the mountain.
So he stood up for the rights of disabled persons.
Very good.
Anybody else we've studied and learned about that stood up for...
That's an impressive class, you guys. We learned a lot of good stuff. You're a good teacher.
No, it's not just me. All of these folks, we have students
job.
From American University. We have folk that are committed to helping our children realize the light in a time of darkness.
Well, I think what you're seeing here, you know, is one of those things that future kids will learn about. I think we have that potential to really create something that can really change things in this country. So this is the beginning of, I think, what may become a pretty significant movement, where people are finally standing up. So I think you're seeing the beginning of something that could be significant. You mentioned Gandhi. Gandhi is someone we talk about a lot, because he was in a situation where there was an occupying power, Great Britain. England was trying to control India, and he was able to help to remove the English from India through a series of nonviolent actions. We emphasize nonviolence here too. We take a lot of lessons from Gandhi and Dr. King, Martin Luther King, and try to learn that strategic use of nonviolence can actually make a big difference against a more powerful opponent. In fact, Gandhi told, it's very much like the 99% movement, because Gandhi told the British when they asked him, what do you think, we're just going to leave? And Guy says, when you see us not cooperating and resisting, you'll recognize it's in your interest to leave. And that's very much like the 1%. You know, we're challenging the 1% wealthiest, but we have the people. And so it's very much like what Gandhi was trying to do there. So he was a perfect example for us to...
All right, cool.
Some more, yeah.
Oh, you're so honest. You're so honest. You gave one back. Anyone need help putting it on? You got it under control? Can we help you?
Okay, I want a pen. If
you have one. Can you get one?
Nobody wants a sticker.
Cocoa.
He's got smaller hands than I do.
Now those are hard to put on. They're not the easiest. They got almost little. I know that's the problem. Big fingers are hard to do it with.
Well, you probably can finish it off. You got open. You got to put it back in.
She poked me.
I did not poke you.
Did you poke him? She did it. She did it non-violently.
I poked you straight.
The police stop when they need to stop.
Well, sometimes. Anyone stickers? Anyone?
Oh yeah, you guys got to get the stop the machine sticker.
Yeah. You want a sticker? You got one? You want a sticker? Where should I put it?
Well, that's good. It means he's going to stop the machine twice. Look at all those buttons.
We come down here sometimes. Sometimes we have movies. We have dinners sometimes. There's all sorts of activities down here all the time.
I think his question is, are you taking care of your responsibilities?
He said, oh, at home. Well, that's a harder thing right now.
It's very hard. We've been here for over 2 weeks.
Yeah, that's a hard thing.
My wife's wondering where I'm at.
We may be out here in the winter.
Wow.
We'll see how it goes.
Wow.
Well, we hear rumors the police are coming, so I'm not sure.
I thought they gave you a 4-month extension.
They did, but...
not to do what we're doing.
Maybe it's not supposed to apply for it, but all these tents, our food tent, those are all we need.
Wow.
All right, so any other questions for Brother Kevin? Because unfortunately we have to go. So parents, I'll get you all back by 5:30. Any other questions?
Okay. All right.
I'm going to get one of those and put it on the back of my phone. I saw what you did of a sticker, and I'm going to put it on. I see that, and the children shall lead us.
They sure will.
I'm going to put my sticker over the Samsung sign.
Get rid of that corporate logo.
That's right. It's a logo for the people.
Yeah, that's right.
I got to stop the machine. Every time I go to answer my phone, stop the machine.
Yeah.
It's going to ring in my ear.
Well, I'm so glad you came down.
Oh, Brother Kevin, thank you. I'm going to try and bring them back again another
time. Thank you.
We have some more time.